Hello people, welcome back. So solutions for first mock test. We'll continue with the AP bifurcation and AP history questions in this session. So exams A to Z, you can follow us on Telegram channel as well as the website for the latest APPSC answer writing program that is going on. And Telegram channel has a lot of quizzes being conducted as well as the newspaper clippings that can be helpful for your preparation in both English and Telugu language. So you do utilize it platform, guys. So let's quickly begin with the solutions. Before I start off the group 2 online test series, our group is starting from 19th April onwards, and already a free mock test is available on the platform. Do call us and register your name, and you can even now take the free mock test by registering your name on this number, so that a test of 150 questions on the pattern of group 2 based on English and Telugu language is available. With this test series program, you can cover around like 5100 questions. With this, you get on add-on programs like personal guidance program as well as monitoring your performance regularly and what to read and what not to read, what are the sources and all that stuff. Everything will be dealt in this online test series. It's just not an online test series, guys. It's much more than that. That is why it's unique. So do utilize this platform and do call us and register if you haven't written the mock test until now, and then come back to this video and get the solutions done. So here I begin with the first question, which was that section 93 of AP Reorganization Act deals with which of the provisions. So the first option deals with the section 46, which says that the 14th Finance Commission has to take the resources that were available and make it separate according to the awards presented to them. Then the second option, which deals with the declaration of Polavaram Irrigation Project, is mentioned under Article 90. The first option is related to 46. And then if you see, the third option is actually the section 93, which is the right answer for this question. The details of the institutions and infrastructure that to be developed will be outlined in the 13th schedule will be dealt in the section 93. So this forms the answer to this question. But the important discussion for the solution discussion with you people is that, so how to eliminate the other options and what the other options also relate to, we wanted to tell you that. That is the reason we have made this video also. So then let's see in that note, on that note only, let's see the fourth option also. The fourth option is nothing but it's regarding the section 94, which says that appropriate fiscal measures have to be taken to promote the industrialization after the bifurcation has been done. So this is overall these sections which are important, based on which commitments have been laid under the AP Reorganization Act. The next question is regarding your taxes that we get money or the budgetary resources are based upon. So basically the revenue that is incoming for the government, it comes from the direct taxes, indirect taxes as well as the non-tax revenues. So this question is based upon the non-tax revenues. Before that, direct tax are nothing but you have this income tax, then you have your corporate wealth and capital gains tax. So this capital gains tax is ruled out here itself because it is a non-tax revenue. It is not a non-tax revenue, whereas and the question is asking about which of the following doesn't come under non-tax, and capital gains tax is about a direct tax. So it comes under the direct tax provisions, whereas you can also get money or incur revenue from your indirect tax such as the GST or your custom duty also. The non-tax revenues are nothing but the first three options are the non-tax revenues, like the fines and penalties, and which are like the RTI from the passport services, driving license services, then fines and penalties like the traffic violation, whichever fines and penalties you pay for it, income from the PSUs, gifts and grants through the foreign aid also, all of them comes under the non-tax revenue. Whereas the answer to this question is option D. Next slide, the percentage of the non-tax revenue that is estimated over the budget. Well, how much is the percentage? The percentage is about 67.45%, which is the first option is the right one. Around 2963 crores have been estimated to be generated towards the non-tax revenue. That is an overall revised estimate for the budget session of 2018-19, and it is estimated to generate over and about 7355 crores. These has been provisions directly have been lifted from your budget itself. So budget, please do refer. The upcoming budget also is important for your upcoming group 2 online exams, right? So the next question is about the infrastructure projects. Infrastructure projects, if I have to give you some information, total like 8 infrastructure projects have been mentioned. So this option is wrong. So assurance is given for the infrastructure projects according to the act in the schedule 13 of the AP Reorganization Act of 2014. And till now, only like initial stages of implementation, only 3 projects are being implemented right now. And then the non-implemented programs are 5, like the Durgarajpatnam port, your integrated steel plant at Karapa, greenfield crude oil refinery projects, then your new railway zones, metro rail facility at the Vijayawada, Guntur, Tenali, as well as the Visakhapatnam areas. So all of these are not implemented as of now. Only three have been implemented, like the Vizag Chennai Industrial Corridor. You have the expansion of the airports to the international standards at Tirupati, Visakhapatnam and Vijayawada. And you have also this rapid rail and road connectivity from the new capital, which is going on. So initial three stages of projects are being implemented and five are not implemented. And total eight infrastructure projects are mentioned under this Act of Schedule 13. So the answer for this question is about A. So the other two options go wrong. Questions like this on this slide will actually give you lots of information, extra information, where you have to read and how to utilize the information provided in your socio-economic survey. These questions will emphasize on that. So all of the three options in this particular question are right, like AP Urban Water Supply, IIB Bank is supporting and implementing this project. Then the Rural Connectivity Project by New Development Bank, as well as the Visakhapatnam Chennai Industrial Corridor, VCIC, is being encompassed in the four nodes region, which has already been asked in your group 1 exams, also group 2 exams. So these are the provisions you just have to pick up, and extra information is being provided through these kind of a framing of the question. So the answer for this question is D. Then we come here to the zero budget national programming farming, which AP has initiated in which of the year. So the year is 2015. For this financial year of 2015 and 16, it has initiated. As you know, the zero budget farming depends upon a very basic important principles. Principles like which we use the locally available materials, we don't use the pesticides, fertilizers and the extra material that is required for its bumper crop. We always use the Jeevanamrita and then all the organic material that is available in and around the locality to grow up the crops and fruits and vegetables. That is what is intended through the zero budget farming program, where AP government has initiated from the 2015. This slide, the question mentioned here is about which of the following are the incorrect statement. I'll give you the direct answer as D. The unemployment rates in the urban areas are actually higher than the rural areas of Andhra Pradesh. The statement has been directly lifted from your socio-economic survey, where the other options, all of the three options are right, that overall employment rate for Andhra Pradesh is higher than the India, and then unemployment rate, then in rural areas of Andhra Pradesh have an unemployment rates that have increased from 2011 to 17. And another statement says that unemployment is actually lower than that of the India's rural and urban areas combined together. So all of the three statements are right, but the actual incorrect statement is option D. We'll come to the YSR Raitu Bharosa scheme that was launched on 15th October 2019. What are the provisions of this scheme is that the government will pay the entire premium amount for the crop insurance with interest-free loans. 9 hours of free electricity will be provided. Aquaculture farmers will get around like 1.5 rupees per unit electricity charges. Price stabilization fund of 3000 crores will be guaranteed through the MSPs. So natural calamities relief fund will be also given. There is the ex gratia component for the suicidal and accidental death of the farmers. And you have lots of tourist facilities and the back-end infrastructure that is being developed. So all of the provisions under the YSR Raitu Bharosa scheme, where per annum you will be paid about 12,500 rupees into your accounts as an input support program. That is what is Raitu Bharosa program is all about. And the launch date was 15th October 2019. So this slide is also about some of the other schemes under the Navratnalu. So one of the scheme is for the welfare of the poor and underprivileged, for making their growth more inclusive. SEST Minorities Welfare Scheme. So under the AP government, what is it? The answer provision here is about, the correct answer is C, which mentions that every wedding gift for all the people who are getting married under the SEST, under the YSR Pellukanuka scheme, will be getting 1 lakh rupees. So what are the other answers for the other options, why they are wrong, we'll just see. Monthly honorarium of rupees 5000 will be provided only for every pastor. It is not 6000 rupees. So it is 5000, you have to just mention. And you have many other corporations that are being established, but it is not in four corporations, only three major corporations will be established. That is the important thing. And free power of provisions that will be provided for monthly of rupees 6000 rupees to every household for SEST colonies. Apart from that, we have lots of other provisions for the SC and ST minority people, like a sub plan will be designed. You have for imams, pastors, for them constructing houses for them. And then you have about an ex gratia of 5 lakhs for the accidental deaths of these people under these Muslim and Christian community. So all of these provisions are also mentioned in your Navratnalu scheme.
And when you glance through the pages of your last few chapters, like 242 and 243 pages of your socioeconomic survey, you can get the information regarding these schemes very well. So do check out all these programs, because the exam will be focusing on the government initiatives as well. Next question is about the Ammavadi scheme. Ammavadi scheme has actually been launched on 26th of January, not 25th. And it is what? It is giving every mother who will send her children to school under the Ammavadi scheme will get 15,000 per year under her bank account. That is what the scheme is all about. So, and then the maintenance fee of 20,000 per annum for all the SEST people will be also provided under the scheme. That is the main provision. And the actual answer to this question is C, that it is aiming to substantially improve the state of schools by next 2 years. That is important. Maintenance fee of only 20,000 is being given, and it will also consider the courses for engineering and colleges as well. The scheme is extended to, whereas this option is wrong because it says that it is not considering. So the answer for this question is C. This slide here again mentions some of the schemes and how much amount has been allocated to it. So the answer to this question is all of the above. If you see, the YSR Tribal University gets a 50 crore allocation. Then Sunna Vaddi Pathakam will give credit facilities for the rural self-help groups, the women in the rural and urban areas. Home Guards will enhance a remuneration of 21,300. All of the options are right. This question of social security benefits, if you see, the first option, you must have marked it right. But see guys, read the statement properly. It has increased the old age pension, no doubt, to 3,000 per rupee per month and in a phased manner, because the actual intention of the scheme is to make it to 3,000 rupees. But they now in a phased manner, they're increasing every 500 rupees, but now they wanted to actually bring it to 3,000. And then the next question, the next point about 25 lakh houses will be constructed in the next 5 years. And this is only 1 lakh rupees that is being provided under the natural death as an insurance coverage. And then pension of 10,000, not 20,000, 10,000 will be provided to the thalassemia and kidney patients, will be provided under the social safety nets. Then there are some factual questions that are being asked in the examination, like this: ki, total revenue receipts of 2019 and 20, which is will be estimated at what point of amount? This is the answer for this question. I am not discussing what it is about because these are some of the factual questions. They just have to be remembering the word names and the schemes names and the amount allocated. So not much explanation into it. The next question is about the part of GST that forms the state's tax revenue. How much is it? 36% in the pie chart. It is represented in your socioeconomic survey as well as budget in the initial terms only. Please do remember such kind of a factual questions answers. So this slide, the answer to this factual question is option D, which is 82,793. This amount of crores of rupees of 46% of total revenue that we are getting through the own state budgetary resources according to the budget. Then the next question is about which of the following is incorrect. The answer is the D, because textile and apparels is only one in number, not two. And there are food processing only one in number. ITES related sectors, SEZs are four in number, whereas the operational SEZs also are 19 in number. Total infrastructure projects that are being managed are 23 in number in the state of Andhra Pradesh. So which of the following airports doesn't come under the greenfield airports? Greenfield airports are nothing but which will start from the scratch, which will be like initiated from the land acquisition to the building of the infrastructure. So what are these airports? Domestic airports, we already know that actually 6 operational airports are present in Andhra Pradesh right now, guys. So in that, domestic airports, Rajahmundry, Kadapa, Orvakul at Karnool and Puttaparthi are private, are the domestic airports that are running. At international level, we are running only 3 airports, which is Visakhapatnam, Vijayawada and Tirupati. So here, if you see, I have already told, we are already operating the Tirupati. So Tirupati forms the correct answer for this question. Whereas Kuppam, Dagarthi, Orvakul, then Ongol, Tadepalligudem are some of the 5 major greenfield projects that are being initiated for the airport sector. Next comes the waterways. So waterways, what is the importance of waterways? It's the inland water transport system, which is the most cheapest mode of the transport. So the National Waterways 4 is designed to have a very logistic channel, which is reliable and cost effective also. And this is about like extending from Kakinada to Puducherry canal system along the river Godavari and river Krishna. And almost like it is with a length of 1078 kilometers, guys, which is like passing on from Vijayawada, Rajahmundry, Kakinada, Eluru, Bhadrachalam, Wazirabad and Chennai also. So if you see all of the options which I mentioned, like there are like Vijayawada, Rajahmundry, Kakinada, Eluru, Bhadrachalam, Wazirabad and Chennai. So all of these three options does come under these places where the National Waterways 4 passes on. The only option that doesn't pass is the Kuppam. So Kuppam forms the answer to this question.
So the next question is AP Disaster Recovery Program project is under which organization that do we run with it? Is the answer directly to this question is World Bank. Next question is, if you see the options, I have just jumbled it. This is the second. Andhra Pradesh is standing second in cashew, mango, turmeric and sweet orange, whereas it's standing first in chilies, cocoa and lime. And the answer actually to this question is option C, where we stand our second largest after Karnataka in production of silk. Then we have this third D option, which is actually 8% growth only we have achieved through the micro irrigation projects in AP. From here, I'll start off the AP history session. I won't be discussing the basic or background information. For that, you have to just get into the Telugu version of the same video, which will be explained by the other members of the exams A to Z team. So I'll be just discussing the answers here, which will be relevant for your solution for the AP history part, right? So the first question is about the which rock edict of Ashoka mentions about the people of Andhra Pradesh is the option C of 13th rock edict. And in Ikshvaku period, what are these trade groups or the guilds called as? Trade groups are all called as Nigamas in the period of Ikshvaku. So this question of Navanada Charitra was written by Srigiri Kavi is the answer. Then Hari Vilasam of Srinada was dedicated to this king of Prolaya Vema Reddy is the answer for this question. So here again, Kavitrika Simham is Vedantika Desika, and then Yakshaganam first in Telugu, which was it? It is about the Sugriva Vijayam, is the play that has been the first Yakshaganam in Telugu. Which Qutub Shahi Sultan minted the first coins in his dynasty was Ibrahim Kuli. And then comes the which of the one of the eight poets who has written the Sugriva Vijayam and all these plays, the first poet also to have written Ashtaka in Telugu language also. He is none other than your Kandukuri Rudrakavi is the answer for this question. The Andhra circular or the Kurnool circular was actually prepared by the Kala Venkatrao, which is the correct answer. Then All India Independence League was actually playing an active role during the Simon Commission boycott movement. Was established by Subhash Chandra Bose and Jawaharlal Nehru. You would obviously mark it because that is a very important independence league that was formed. And Bulsu Sammurthy was also an important member for its establishment. So all of the above is the answer for this question. Who led the Cheerala Perala civil disobedience movement? You just need not even have a second thought about it because the answer to this question is Duggirala Gopal Krishnaya. Then comes your Bipin Chandra has toured Andhra Desam in which year? 1907 is the famous year of Bipin Chandra Pal touring the Andhra Pradesh. The tradition of writing an autobiography of your own life history is about in Telugu language has been started by Kandukuri Veeraselingam. Then the Crescent Patrika or the Chennapatna Swadeshi Society was established by Gajal Lakshmi Narsu Setty is the answer. And the last question for the session is about the importance of the Satavahana inscriptions were written in which language. This is very important and frequently asked questions also, guys. So it is in Prakrit language, which is mentioned in Brahmi script. So this is the answer to this question. So here we go to group 2 online test series schedule. I hope you have understood what kind of explanation, what kind of quality of questions that we are providing in the test series, through which you can just revise all the portions, you can gain a lot of knowledge as well as you can assess your performance at your doorstep itself, because it's an online test series and you can call us and register your name for the free mock test that is still live. Before 19th April itself, you can attend this test and get a handhold approach of how the program is going to be, and we will be provided with personal guidance program also along with this online test series. The total number of tests would be 5,100 questions, which will make your name into the final list of group 2 in the upcoming exam. So in the next session, in the next video, I'll be coming with the other subjects, because polity, bifurcation, AP economy and the AP history portion has already been covered in 2 videos. So the next portion I'll be coming with the current affairs and the other portions. So until then, happy learning, stay tuned.